Not the taste. Pull up straight from Tokyo. Hey everybody, I'm here with my cousin Gabriella Alyssa. Introduce me now.
And I'm here with my cousin Jolie Ines. So we're just going to do a video where we ask each other questions and then we do what are the chances. So we'll ask
what
a question.
Are the odds?
What are the odds?
Are you ready?
Yeah.
I'm ready.
You go first then.
Okay. My first question is, how many guys have you kissed that you aren't dating or weren't dating?
We should do 1 through 2. I think we should. 1 through 2.
Ready?
Set. Go.
2. 1.
I don't even understand this question, but I found it anyways. We're just gonna ask it. I have a lot of other questions anyways. Would you kiss the last person you kissed?
Set,
go.
2.
You said, come here. You did. You got my face and I was like crying to
Alicia. Oh my gosh.
Okay. Alicia!
It's so funny.
Shout out Alicia.
We love Alicia.
We love Alicia.
Okay. Where is the craziest place you've used the bathroom?
I was expecting something else.
Plot twist.
1, 2, 3, 1. 2.
What the?
You thought it was gonna change.
Okay.
Okay, what's your biggest beef with someone in our family and who?
You really did me like that.
Okay.
It's gonna get juicy. Okay, ready?
1, 2, 3, 1.
Oh, okay. What's the riskiest text that you've ever sent? And to who?
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 2, 1. You're like, hey, baby boy.
Yes.
Are you lost, baby boy?
You lost. How many people have you kissed? I feel like you want to answer this one.
Okay, count first and then.
Yeah.
Jeez.
1, 2, 3, 1. 2.
Wow. Oh. All right. We're actually pretty good at
it. Your turn. What's the first thing you do if you woke up as a boy?
Look at my dick.
I didn't even count.
Question is. Have you ever peed on your partner?
1, 2, 3, 2. 1.
Are you kidding me?
You were so bad.
All right. Okay. When was the last time you told a lie and what was it? Ready? And tell me.
1, 2, 3, 2.
Yes! Freaking finally!
When was the last time I told a lie?
And what was it?
It was probably yesterday to your mom when she walked in and we were drinking that.
Oh, that drink.
She was like, I see you guys. And she's like, whose is that?
And I was like, almost like ripped my head off.
I was like, it's my dad's.
What's your biggest turn on?
This is like easy, but like
1, 2, 3, 1.
Yes. Physical or like character wise?
Physical, duh.
She's like the size of his honker. Back muscles.
So that way when there's scratches on it, it looks
good. Alright,
picture.
What was the last fight you had with your mans and what was it about? 1, 2, 3, 2. Ow!
Maybe today's.
Yeah, no. That's why I put it on there.
Don't be shy, put some more!
Ow!
Sorry.
Okay.
Whoops. He told me that we wouldn't be doing, like, something anymore that we like usually do that I enjoy.
It was playing with her honkers.
Have you ever hit somebody like with your car and drove away?
Two, three, one.
No.
Have you?
We're not gonna talk about it.
Jeez. I've gotten out of a ticket.
I do.
I was like, hi, officer. I'm just kidding.
You're like, hi, officer.
What is the most illegal thing you've done? I know what it is. One, two, three, one.
Two.
You didn't even need a cover up.
I didn't even need a cover up. Have you ever had lice?
I saw this one online.
One, two, three, one.
Two.
One! I said one.
Ew! What is the most embarrassing pic of you and show it?
One, two, three, one.
Ah! What's your bra size?
Two! Hit me so freaking hard. It's still welted.
Darn.
What body type on a guy do you like better, beer belly or twig?
Ready? One, two, three,
twig.
Two.
Oh,
fuck. What about you?
Beer belly.
When was the last time you popped a curb?
Two, three, one. That would be today, ladies and gentlemen. Approximately 3 hours ago. Harden or Massimo?
Massimo.
Fuck you.
Take me back to Poland.
It wants my laptop and phone.
Yeah, Massimo's a man and then Harden's still like...
He's boy.
Yeah.
Massimo, for sure.
Massimo.
Sorry, Harden Sky. Love you, baby. Have you ever had a crush on... several different guys that all have the same name?
One, two, three, one. Yes.
Can you say how many of them that there were?
Four.
Oh. Has there ever been a rumor spread about you? And what was it?
Probably that I was secretly dating someone in my friend group from like a while ago. Dating experience you regret. I guess I'll just answer my own questions with you. Dating experience you regret and who?
He like would like say what he wanted to do and it kind of scared me. So I kind of regret wanting to date that young.
Dating experience I regret. Freshman year boyfriend. Yeah, that was a no. It's the most annoying thing I do.
Honestly, it's when we're sleeping and you just start talking in your sleep. Like, you're not even whispering or like being quiet. You're having a full-on conversation and it's loud. This happened this week. You were talking and I don't know what you said and I was like, what?
The most annoying thing that you do.
I didn't ask.
Smack me with things. Anything that she'll be carrying, and if she's passing by me or I'm near her, she just has to smack me over the head with it.
I have a question.
What?
Have you ever been jealous of me?
Maybe if it was like over something that you were like allowed to do but I wasn't allowed to do.
And me
when
we're now
younger.
It's the reverse.
Now it's the reverse. Have you ever been jealous of me?
Yeah.
For what? Why'd you say it like that?
Go serious. How much attention and time you got in the relationship. Mm. And like how he was always there.
Yeah.
He always wanted to be there.
Yeah.
I was like, I'm genuinely so happy that you had that because I didn't and I know how it like sucks.
Yeah.
To feel that way. They were just two like different people, affection wise.
I feel like you don't realize like how different, like I guess people like show their love and like love people. I was also just like really comfortable and used to a relationship where someone like cared a lot and loved really hard.
Yeah. I think that once like certain relationships end and like you have time to like move on and then like kind of reflect on them and stuff like that, I feel like you realize like, I feel like you can be more grateful for like things that you did gain from that relationship, and like whether it was how that person treated you or just certain things. And yeah,
sorry.
How did your last relationship end?
I just felt like the relationship with him, like it was really good, but he was too nice.
Yeah.
Like,
you almost feel like he might have wanted something out of it or something.
Not that, I feel like he was too nice, it just was like too
perfect.
Like, yeah.
Yeah.
You go, you? I wasn't gonna answer it. My last relationship ended because we were just going different ways, I feel like, and in some ways we just grew apart, and yeah, I guess that was just kind of in the end what was best. And, you know, I feel like if something's meant to be, it'll be, and you shouldn't ever try to force something. Oh, and then, like, my very, very last question to end the video is, what is the best piece of relationship advice that you can get?
Always be there for your person, no matter how hard it gets. You have to trust them in all situations. You just really need to, you can't just run away from your problems. Mm-hmm. You have to work it out, because if you really want them, if you really love them, you're gonna do anything for them, no matter how hard things get.
Yeah. And I feel like what you realize as you've actually been in like serious relationships is that, you know, you look at someone in like an innocent crush way before you've ever actually dated someone for real, and you're like, oh my gosh, I'd love to date that person. But then like, and I've talked to you about this, but then like you realize, then you like actually date someone and you realize that there's so much more to a relationship. You gotta be able to put up with everything about their personality. You gotta be able to help handle their emotions and be there for them with whatever they're going through. So it's like you take a whole nother person into your hands, and it's not just you anymore. It's not just like butterflies and rainbows all the time, and there's these moments where you just genuinely need to be able to know how to care for someone else's emotions and just be there for that person through thick and thin.
Don't fight for someone that's not gonna fight for you.
Amen.
We're back on our cheesy bullshit.
Okay, so I just got home from New Mexico a few days ago, and I've been editing the video, and I realized that I completely forgot or just didn't ever end up giving my piece of advice as far as relationships go when we were filming the video. So my eyes are dilated as heck, so I can't even see the quality, so I apologize in advance. But yeah, so I just want to give my piece of advice, which was that in a relationship, you know, like in order to build healthy trust and just be able to trust each other in general, I guess, you shouldn't ever restrict the person that you're dating as far as, you know, like who they can talk to or like things they can do. Because I feel like if you restrict someone or you try to control someone from doing something or talking to someone, I think that you become kind of the fool in that situation, because it's like, if that person wants to do that thing, why would you want to be like in a relationship with someone who's going to want to or like be tempted to cheat on you or be tempted to do something behind your back and lie to you about it? It's like, why would you want to be in a relationship like that? There's the quote that all things come to light, and it's actually a Spanish quote, but that's generally the translation. That essentially means that anything that your partner does or whatever and stuff like that, you're gonna find out eventually. You shouldn't be in a position where you feel like, oh, I want to keep them from the world or this and that, and I just want them all to myself, and if I do this or if I do that, then they're not going to want to do that, or then they won't be able to do it. But it's just like, in the end, it's going to be putting you in the position where you're down here, and you should be the person who's up here. Because if your relationship is meant to be, and if you guys have a good, healthy relationship and trust in your relationship, then you should both be able to make your own decisions, and you shouldn't ever feel like you have to restrict whoever you're in a relationship with. But I feel like that is the best piece of advice I can give as far as relationships go. But yeah, that's about it, and I'll see y'all in the rest of the outro.
Okay, well, that was our whole video. It kind of went from like playing a game to like serious conversation.
That's how most of our nights end.
Thank you for watching this video. If you did, obviously, I appreciate it.
Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Is that how we do it? You're cutting that one out. Can I redo that?
I love making videos with Jolie because she's literally my best friend, but my cousin at the same time, and I don't know. I just have such a high tolerance for her, and I feel like she should feel really lucky. Okay, alright, but that was the video. Thank you for watching again, and good night.